This historic opportunity belongs to the people.
The Voice will re-racialise our nation.
Disinformation and misinformation and scare campaigns.
This is starting to get into a really disgraceful campaign, and the campaign hasn't even started yet.
It's a question of recognition, but a debate that's fast turning ugly.
The Prime Minister out there name-calling people and others suggesting that people are racist because they don't support The Voice. It's completely and utterly unacceptable.
It's very difficult for Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people right now because the vitriol, the racism on social media has really increased.
This week, the lower house is expected to pass the bill for the referendum, and the Yes campaign is set to kick off in earnest. But as opposing Voice campaigns grow louder, it's feared racism will follow.
This referendum is dividing Australia.
I think it's important to remember the referendum in itself does not seek to divide. There are obviously elements of tension that are creeping in.
Amid warnings the world is watching, the chair of Wesfarmers today claimed foreign investors would be driven away should the referendum fail.
If we don't get that up, obviously, it's going to leave a question mark about our commitment towards supporting the rights of Indigenous peoples in our own country.
I think the Indigenous voice to Parliament's a great idea, and I think it's long overdue.
Unfortunately, it is seeming to become a racial debate.
It's an absolute yes. This always was and always will be Aboriginal land.
But as recent polls suggest, support for The Voice is wavering. Could this referendum ruin our reputation if Australia says no?
If the referendum fails, then it's unthinkable. It's Australians officially saying no to recognising the existence of Indigenous people. We would see as a quite a backward country if we cannot achieve this simple and modest proposal to listen to Indigenous people.
Please welcome Yes campaigner and leader of Victoria's First People's Assembly, Marcus Stewart. It's nice to see you, Marcus.
Thanks for having me.
Are you worried The Voice is failing before it even really gets started?
I'm not worried it's failing. I mean, the trend isn't looking good at the moment, but we've got to think about it and offer some perspective. The bill hasn't passed the lower house yet. The mechanics of the Yes campaigns haven't even started, so we've got a responsibility to go out and educate the Australian public on what The Voice is and what it isn't. So campaign hasn't started yet. Obviously, the trend isn't great, but we're confident that come referendum night or the Sunday after, not only having the opportunity to wake up a better country, but we hope that we win this.
You're right, Marcus. It is early days, but for someone like me who's inclined to vote no when the referendum comes around, the PM tonight, right as we sit here, is making a speech calling people like me, Chicken Little, and someone who's a doomsayer. How's that contributing to reasoned debate, that sort of name-calling?
Well, Steve, I think what's important is that we have the opportunity to talk to Australians about what this is and what this isn't. There's an opportunity to change the status quo for Aboriginal people. 65,000 years of history we have in this country, whether you're a traditional owner of country or whether you live on Aboriginal land as a non-Indigenous person, we've got an opportunity to improve the lives of Aboriginal people. And what's important in this debate is not the dis and misinformation that's out there or the scare tactics. We need to present the facts, the truth on what this can achieve. But this will be achieved together. Aboriginal people and non-Indigenous people walking together to achieve this outcome.
So you don't think The Voice is a stretch too far? I mean, I have no argument whatsoever of Indigenous inclusion in the Constitution. I think that would get up easily. But I still don't understand, and I am a little suspicious of the next bit.
Yeah. I think it's modest. I think it can deliver tangible outcomes. We know the statistic through closing the gaps. We know that data. It's horrifying. I don't think there's any Australian that wants to see that get worse. We want to make improvements. We want to do better as a country. How do we do that? We put Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people in the driver's seat for decisions that disproportionately impact them. Give them a say, give them a fair go on matters that impact them and them alone.
How do you think this plays out from an international perspective? So if it fails, how do you think Australia's going to be looked at on the global stage?
Well, if we take a step back and think about Australia's unique place on the international stage, we have 65,000 plus years of history, the oldest living culture in the world, something that's part of all of our stories living on Aboriginal land. That's something we can celebrate. It's something we can recognise. It's something that our kids should feel a sense of connection to and our grandkids feel a sense of belonging to. We've got a story to tell here, and we need to look at ways that we bring each other together, not further apart. And on the back of a no vote, I think it doesn't look good in the international community, that's for sure.
Do you think Australians respond to that? Like, the world won't like us, they will think that we're a bit strange or that we're backward or something like that?
I mean, it's a good question, and I honestly don't know. I think what's important, and if I think about what we have to do between now and the day of the referendum, is we have to explain, we have to win the hearts and minds of our fellow Australian. Maybe Australians won't respond to that, but it doesn't mean that it's not a reality. It doesn't mean that we may be embarrassed on the international stage. But that's not our priority. That's not my priority. My priority is making sure that I can reach as many people, Australian people, who will be in the ballot box. So then when they stand in the solitude of that ballot box and they reckon with their conscience or whether they write yes or no, that we hope they write yes.
What happens if they write no? What does that mean for Australia?
Well, there's going to be people that will write no. We understand that. But, I mean, it'd be heartbreaking to think the country we wake up to on that Sunday on the back of a no vote. It's amazing to think what we may wake up to as a country on the back of a yes vote, being able to meet that aspiration with that moment to say that First Nations lives in this country matter and we all can roll our sleeves up as Australians, as the best country in the world, to make a difference.
Would you take a no vote as Australia saying they don't matter?
It's pretty hard to see how it wouldn't.
All right. There's a lot on the line, the way you framed it. Marcus, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.